Okay, Chris, I am ready to make the vomit factory. What do I do?
First of all, get your balloon and attach it to the bottom of the funnel. Now get the bicarbonate of soda. 2 or 3 big spoonfuls will do. In this case, the funnel is representing the mouth. The neck of the funnel is the esophagus, the tube that goes from the back of your mouth down through your chest to your stomach in your abdomen. And the balloon is the stomach itself. The next step is to make the food that's going to get vomited in the plastic bottle. So Zond, put lots of vinegar into the plastic bottle. About half of that bottle. Now, vinegar, it's got an acid in it called acetic acid.
When the acetic acid mixes with the bicarbonate of soda, it reacts and releases a gas called carbon dioxide.
That is going to build up pressure in the balloon, and it's going to drive the vomit factory.
There we go, Chris, half a bottle of vinegar.
So let's add a couple of drops of food coloring.
This has particularly puketastic mess potential, so lay down lots of protective stuff, wear an apron, and make sure that you have adult supervision.
So let's add 2 drops of green, then just a few drops of yellow. Good, that's enough.
Right! Don't panic, Chris, it's only food coloring.
It's only vomit. That's enough, that's enough.
Look at that, you're the most cautious food coloring user in history.
Well, now we're going to add some green peas, chunks of carrot.
What appears to be carrot in vomit is actually part of your stomach lining. This mixes with these food scraps, which is undigested food in your stomach.
And then, finally, some washing up liquid. Now, in your vomit, you've got lots and lots of mucus from your saliva that you've produced and also from the stomach mucus itself. And that's going to foam up. That's why we're adding the detergent.
It's looking good.
It is looking good.
It's a perfect vomit mixture.
It is. So now what Zond's going to do is connect the balloon to the top of the bottle, but taking great care not to mix the contents yet.
Those are now ready to be mixed. I'm going to hand them to Chris because I will be doing the cinematography of this scene using 360-degree vomit cam! Now, it's a good time to remind you what happens when you vomit. First of all, you get that feeling that something bad's gonna happen, the nausea, the sense of impending doom, and that's your cue to get to a bucket or a bathtub or a toilet or a sink. Next thing that happens is you take a deep breath and you close your epiglottis so that no vomit can get into your lungs. And what happens then, Chris?
This is the stomach. The exit is called the pyloric sphincter, and that will close so that when the stomach squeezes, it doesn't force the food further down the gut. But it also closes, for the time being, the esophageal sphincter,
which is the ring of muscle we saw in the pig's stomach
that stops food normally going back up towards your mouth. Are you ready, Zond?
I'm ready. I've got the vomit cam on it.
Here we go.
Force that.
There. That's good. Keep squeezing it. Oh, careful!
That's good. Now, the bicarb and the acid have started to react and produce carbon dioxide. So the pressure inside the stomach is now rising. The gastroesophageal sphincter, it's going to open and the stomach's going to squeeze out all the food at once.
Are you ready, Chris?
I'm ready. It's going to blow.
It's puke time.
That's horrendous.
Wow! Look at the speed and power of that. Your stomach and abdominal muscles have all contracted to force the vomit out.
You've got it all over my kitchen, Chris. What are you doing?
I'm really sorry about that. It turns out my vomit factory was too good.